If you want to get more app installs, this video is perfect for you because I'm going to hold your hand and guide you step by step in creating your own Google Ads app installs campaign. I have been using Google Ads for the past 7 years, so I'm very familiar with the ins and outs of the platform, and some of the things that Google Ads recommends for you aren't actually that good for you. So make sure you stay through to the end of the video so you don't miss anything in this campaign creation process, all right? Are you ready? Let's get straight into it. So the first thing you guys are gonna do is head over to ads.google.com and either create an account, which will be a very simple process, or simply click on sign in. Once you do that, you will land on a page that looks something like this. Now, as a side note, it might look a little bit different for you because Google Ads always split tests different interfaces for different people, okay? So if it looks a little bit different, don't freak out. It might be different for everybody. So from this menu, you're gonna look for the campaign tab. So you're gonna click on campaigns, you're gonna click on the little plus sign, and you will click on new campaign. And then we want to promote our app, right? So we're gonna click on app promotion over here. And over here, we're gonna select app installs. If you don't have an app out yet, you can build some hype for it with this campaign type right here. Or if you want users to actually be active on your app, if that's your goal, not just installs, but to build an engaging audience, you can select app engagement, but you do need at least 250,000 installs for this to work, all right? So we're just gonna go with app installs for now. You're gonna select where your app is, Android or iOS, let's say it's Android. You're gonna type your app here. I don't have an app, so we're just gonna use one of my favorite strategy games here, Uniwar, as an example. And then we're gonna give this a name, Uniwar app. We're gonna click continue. And you're just gonna make sure that this is indeed the app that you're promoting. Now, for location targeting, you're gonna set your geographical location, of course. So let's suppose we wanna target United States and Canada. We're gonna select those, type enter. Now, here's one of those parts where Google says recommended, but it's not really recommended for you, recommended for Google more so. So over here, when you click on these location options, you wanna select this option here, presence, people in or regularly in your target location. If you select this option, you will also be targeting people that are searching for your country. So people in China that say something like Uniwar app in the United States, your ad can show to those people, right? So if you're only restricting your ads to people in a certain geographical location, like US and Canada, only people that live there, you wanna select presence over here, okay? So something for you to keep in mind. The next thing here is languages. So this won't translate your ads. This just says, to whom do you want to show your ads to? People that speak what language? In our case, our ads and everything will be in English, so we're gonna keep it at English. You can also click on more settings. You can enter a start and end date, and you can add a data feed, which you can add here in Google Ads. We won't get into that in this video. It's pretty much irrelevant for this campaign. So we're gonna click on next over here. The next thing we have to do is add a budget. How much are you comfortable with spending? I do have a video that can help you determine what should your budget be. Take a look at that. I will link it in the description. For the purpose of this video, let's suppose we're comfortable with $25 a day. Now it's asking what we want to focus on, install volume, in-app actions, or in-app action value. Now to select these two options, we do need conversion tracking set up. We don't have conversion tracking set up for this specific campaign. However, I do strongly advise you that before you run this campaign, you do set up conversion tracking. Again, I do have a video showing you exactly how to do that step by step. I will link that video in the description. But we're gonna click on install volume here. We're gonna say that this is our app and we wanna target all users. Again, over here, we can select this option only if we have conversion tracking set up. So that looks good. We could set a target cost per install. So let's suppose we don't wanna pay more than $1 per install. Keep in mind, this is only a target, okay? You will still be paying per click and you might still pay more than $1 per install, but this just gives Google a little bit of direction, okay? So we're gonna click on next over here. And now this is where we're gonna set our headlines and where we can preview what our ad will look like on Google Display, Google Search, YouTube, Discover, Google Play, okay, everywhere. So it looks pretty cool. If you can't see your ad, play around with your extensions because sometimes the ad block extension will prevent you from seeing your ad here, which is pretty important. So if you don't see your preview here, just disable some of those extensions that could be interfering. So we can enter headlines, descriptions, images, HTML, videos. Okay, so let's start with the headlines. So Google should recommend some things for us here, a game for strategy lovers, and that's about it, but sometimes it gives more suggestions. So we could also type something, for example, like better than chess. And I don't like this period at the end, we're gonna remove it. We're gonna say the best strategy game ever. As a testimonial, we're gonna put it in quotes as an example. And then we can add more headlines if you like. So if you have conversion tracking set up, you can add as many headlines, as many descriptions as you can, because Google will play around and try to figure out the best one. If you don't have conversion tracking set up, it's not really gonna matter much because you won't know which one converts the best anyway, okay? So very important for you to get that conversion tracking set up. So for the description, let's see what Google recommends to us. Yes, that looks good. Let's add one more here. All right, so I just wrote Uniwar is a great turn-based strategy game that makes you think and improve your strategy. Just something to have there. Next, we can add images. So we can click on images here. It's gonna pull up some suggested images for you, but you can also go into free stock images, which is really cool because usually you have to pay for stock images, but Google Ads integrates with stock images. So let's say war. So this looks kind of cool. So let's go in and use this image. Now, before you actually save, what you do wanna do as well is click on these images and make sure that the dimensions look all good. Put it into the field of vision here that actually looks good. Like over here, let's suppose we wanna move it a little bit more to the left. Or over here, wanna do that. Or let's suppose you don't like the 4x5 dimension here, you can just deselect it and say, okay, I'm gonna pick a different image for my 4x5. This one doesn't look bad, so we'll leave it, but just so you know. And then you can go in and you can select other images if you like. So let's suppose this one. And again, you wanna do the same thing, just make sure that the dimensions look good. So we're gonna click on little icon there. So see, this one, as you can see, is a little harder. You can make it smaller if you like. This one looks okay. This one looks good. Okay, so that looks good. Say we're happy with this. We're gonna click on save. You can also obviously upload your own images. So if you click on upload, you just upload your images, okay, if you have them. So you can also add some videos. So I don't really have any relevant videos here, but you can search on YouTube and let's see if we can find something to do with Uniwar. So here there's a 30-second trailer, which looks pretty cool. So we can add that as an example. Obviously you wanna create your own video. You can set it to unlisted, so it's not actually public, but something that you can use because a video is always helpful, especially for YouTube campaigns, right? HTML5, I'm not sure what that is, but those of you that have created apps, you're probably familiar. You can just go in here and upload your HTML5 media file. And that's pretty much it. And then you can go in here and you can see what your ad will look like. So this is the Uniwar icon. It's automatically being pulled from the app, which is really cool. And then for some of them, it will have images. And you can see here's what it'll look like on search, on YouTube, on Discover. And that's why it's cool if you have a video, because then you can show it on YouTube ads as well, right? You can have it on Google Play. You can also go through the different types of ads because it'll have different headlines, different descriptions. So you can just click on this little next preview button. You can also click play preview and it's just gonna play them all for you so you see what they look like one by one, right? So that looks good. Let's say we're happy. We're gonna click next. Now it says the budget is too low. So let's click on fix it. Let's make it, I don't know, for this example, let's see, $50. It's good enough. Let's click on next. Let's click on next again. Uniwar, where this exists. Okay, let's say Uniwar app 2. Now it's gonna check for errors again. We're gonna make sure everything looks good here. All right, so it looks good. And then you're just gonna scroll down and make sure that everything else here looks good. Your location, your language, your mobile app. Make sure that's the right app, okay? Product groups, your assets, everything looks good here. And we're gonna click on publish campaign. And voila, congratulations, you have successfully created your first app installs campaign. Here you can see the ad group, you can change your assets here. You can also click on the individual ad group here and you can see all the different assets. So you can see all the different headlines, all the different descriptions. You can also click on the edit ad button there and you can change anything around. So add something new, or maybe if you made a mistake, you can replace it, everything over here, and then you can click save. So we're gonna click cancel. You can also, if you come back into the app, you can go into settings and you can go in and adjust the setting options over here. You can adjust your locations here. You can see your change history, all right? So everything here is pretty straightforward, and congratulations, give yourselves a pat on the back. You are now going to start promoting your app to get those installs, all right? And that is pretty much it for this video. If you guys enjoyed this content, I do strongly invite you to check out my website at ivanmana.com. where I offer paid training courses that you can go into and learn how to create profitable Google ad campaigns, learn Google ad retargeting, or if you wanna try something new like Facebook ads or Microsoft ads, you can do that here as well. I also offer you a free affiliate marketing guide. that can help you get started with affiliate marketing, learn what it is, so you can potentially start making money with it today. All right, and that is all. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next video.